for Malam Nasir El-Rufai, who was also the FCT minister. This man embezzled $1 billion. $1 billion. The worst part of it is that the level of money they embezzled, like our rep said, is the money that maybe can, many countries don't have this amount of money in their treasury. Are we talking about the former vice president of Nigeria in the person of Atiku Abubakar? This money, this man, from 1990 to 2007, he embezzled over $500 million. The former central bank governor in the person of Sanusi, Lamido Sanusi. This man. Over $1.2 billion. Are we talking about Abacha? I don't want to talk about Abacha, Abdulsalam Abubakar. Babangida, his own is over $2.4 billion. So this is the only, that is in the area of governance. This is the money they embezzled in governing position. Are we talking about the people that are in business? The whole oil block in Nigeria are owned by Fulanis. If you like, I mentioned there is a particular information I received previously over 6-7 months ago. That one oil block, none of them is less than $5 billion, are owned by only Fulanis. That one piece of oil block, they want to sell them outrightly. Just like my brother Elias said, they want to sell these oil blocks because they observe that things are changing. And if eventually Biafra got what they want, these oil blocks will stay away from their hands. So I don't quite agree with my colleague who said that they are the most corrupt in Nigeria. No, they are not the most corrupt in Nigeria. They are the most corrupt people in the whole world, because without corruption, they cannot exist. They cannot compete with any tribe in Nigeria. They are more corrupt than devil himself. These people are not supposed to be part and parcel of our existence. They are not supposed to near us, because they are not competent with anything that has to do with humanity. These people are devil. So anybody telling me that they are the most corrupt in Nigeria is only is an understatement. Put it that way. It's an understatement. These people are corrupt to the core. Because if you look at, imagine this current man that they are using his name to govern Nigeria today, the late Buhari. There was a woman. Let me get the facts straight. There was a woman. The woman was the founder of Afri Consortium. She was also in charge of PTF account from 1994 to 1997, if I'm not mistaken. This woman stole almost $12.5 million. And you know, one thing with them is that immediately, this elected Buhari emerges as the next president. He also put this woman as a minister in his own regime. So you now see that nepotism is their own. They do everything with impunity. They do it with the fact that nobody can challenge them, because they know that British will always support them and back them up, because British observe that they are the only people, the only willing tools that they can use to achieve their aims in Nigeria. That is why they handed over the control of Nigeria to them. So given all these facts, these people are the most corrupt people on the planet Earth, not only in Nigeria, because the money that is in their position, they cannot use the money they have stole to better their own people. They will only bank this money in a foreign banks, and majority of this money, some of them die without knowing where this money are. And if the countries where they bank this money, like try to get the fat of this money, they will run away and leave those money there. The money meant to develop our place, they will send it to our foreign countries. Those people will use it to better themselves. What are we not talking? Are we talking about the educational sector? Where can we mention that Fulani are doing better? There is no Fulani artist. There is nothing they can do better. I don't know where these people came from. These cursed people just came to destroy us. But I know that with the intervention of Chukwuka Kadiama and the effort our leader is putting, they cannot do anything. So with what I have said so far, I wouldn't want to waste much of our time because I'm on the road. I just want to let all our listeners to understand this morning that Fulani are the most corrupt. As far as humanity exists on the planet Earth, Fulani are the most corrupt. And then when you see, I will stand by while I hand back the microphone to you. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Maze. That is the voice of Maze Okechukwu Egwim. Thank you for your own opinion. And we must continue. What is going on in Nigeria is a very pathetic, very, very terrible, terrible situation. Whereby the main things will be happening, nobody is talking about it. We're not even talking about some moons back. I think some moons back, immediately I perceived that the late Buhari is dead. Immediately when late Buhari is late, they started burning like some part of CBN Abuja got fired, and also burned some part. Some sensitive document is what got burned. Reasons, if anywhere that we implicate them, they try to erase it. All this is well-planned, well-orchestrated. So it's not today. This is people that plan a lot of evil and they never want anybody to. That is why they now come back to the last one. They perfected everything to allocate themselves positions. So how can you now fight for justice in the Zoological Republic? Is it not a doom? It's a doom. Because when you go to the judiciary, go to Supreme Court, go to High Court, everything, even anywhere you go is them. Then control everything. People laws, law enforcement that we enforce the law, they are the one that in charge. When you come to the, in fact, zoo is nothing to write to home about. It's a country that doomed to fail. In fact, it need to be dismembered. That is only solution. And that these people is people that made it possible. Although they are godfather, colonial master, British is out there. There are people that mastermind all these things. There are people that plan everything. That is why these things are happening in the Zoological Republic. And here we now to set record straight. And we want our freedom. That is the bottom line. We want to this country. Why we are saying all these things are saying for the whole world to hear our voice and know the important and the reasons why the Zoological Republic need to disintegrated and dismembered. Because continuation of the Zoological Republic, there is nothing we make the Zoological Republic to become a vibrant nation or for them to have a vibrant economy is impossible. Because the foundation had been laid very wrongly through Britain. They give them Bokos populated, give them a Bokos number during the time of for a group independence. So this is a fact and figures. And with such a thing, there is nothing you can come to do, through democracy. You now want to obtain rights, it will make possible. It's impossible. Because they are located themselves, the highest populated ethnic group. So whatsoever they're doing, they have the populated. If you come through the ballot, that is why they say you go to the ballot paper, you do this, you come to that place, vote for now to the kingdom come, you will never get anything. Because they are in everywhere, everything is well planned. The only solution and the only way forward is to end the Zoological Republic. That is all. That is all. That is why we are here today doing justice to all these evils. We are here to say for you to here we are here to just talk the important and more reason we need to end Nigeria now, not tomorrow. That is all of us are here. Without wasting more time, there is another topic we want to discuss today about what is going on in the Zoological Republic, about Aselok. That is our second topic. And as we can see, everybody will supposed to understand by now that Aselok is empty. Buhari is dead. And why people are being silent? Why the whole world, all of a sudden, everybody are going mute. Nothing, nobody is speaking. Nobody is saying anything. They now come in and persecute an innocent man that he only use when his crime is to use microphone and tell the truth, nothing to the truth. Our leader, Mazin and Kanu. Sometimes I wonder what is going on. When people will now preaching us justice, but even the world people that are saying justice, and we never see them as good justice. So meaning what they said is not what they preach is not what they're doing. Every intelligence all over the world know that Buhari has long time ago died and buried. That Aselok is empty. The young man that is in supervise that is even running affairs of Zoological Republic. Maybe I'm even older than him. He's a very young guy. Very, very young guy. When you look in his own hand, you look like one pretty young lady. Imagine, Buhari should be in the early 80s or late 80s now. An old man, for that sake. So even if you cannot see, you can hear. If you cannot hear, you can perceive. These people have dupox. These people have blinded our eyes. Even when Nigerians know that Buhari is no more, but nobody is courageous enough to say the house lock is empty. Because everybody was afraid of Janjaweed. When you speak, they will kill you. And with these reasons, why we are saying the way we speak, why we talk the way we talk, is for the whole world to hear our voice. Is for the whole world to hear our voice and for them to rescue Biafran by scheduling a date for referendum and release our leader, Mazen Nankan, unconditionally. Because I don't see any reason why the man, young man in Asuroku, Buhari handler, will be doing what we're doing. And we now here and facing Fulani, they're doing anything they want to do because of the Britain giving the march order. They cannot tell me that Britain is there. Fulani are doing what they're doing. They said we don't have power. Nigeria is a sovereign nation. Sovereign nation indeed. And Buhari will fly jet in and go to UK. After coming that place, he will go back and they never deem it fit to do. Anyway, all this is orchestrated. It's only we Biafran to understand what is going on. We don't need another person to tell us what is going on. Our freedom is in our hands for us to stand up and do. And not only Biafran, all the indigenous people in Nigeria must stand up to end the Fulani oligarchy before they will end us. Because it's very obvious. Buhari is no more there. Everything is moving. We have every information here and there. Yet, we choose to turn our blind eyes on it. Even when they say there is a cockroach, whatever in Asuroku, they now buying time for demolish because according to the information, it's only used fingerprint for security purposes. But when Buhari is late, the new Buhari in the person of Jubilee then cannot be able to enter that place until they need to demolish and destroy that man and build a new one. After all these things, we had by almost how many moons before they can be able to build these things. I don't know. And our people are still proud and saying, my country, this is my country. And this. So sometimes I don't understand. Is it mean these thousands of even millions of professors in Nigeria, they're not seeing these things or they're not understanding them? Or they're not feeling the way we are feeling? Or because of hatred they have for Biafrans? I don't understand. Even when truth is staring at our faces, we choose to ignore it. We choose to be silent. I don't understand what is wrong with black man. What another influence are we waiting for? For us to know that Buhari is no more. And for us to take what belongs to us and end this madness in Zoological Republic. I call it madness. In a country whereby we have almost 200 and something million people and a very teeny, very wretched, very, very awkward tribe will come and control over 200 and something million populated nationalities, even most educated people, intelligent people. Only few educated people are controlling them. What is going on? We need to rise up and say enough is enough and end Zoological Republic. But when we are now complaining without doing things, they will continue leaning over us. They will continue issuing all manner of things because Britain give them go ahead order, give them red car, give them what they call it, this, let them go ahead order. That is why they're doing what they're doing. But it's only left for us to say enough is enough and stand up and say enough. But without wasting more time, let me go to Mazudensi, please, I'm coming on to you now. What do you have to say about Asuroku is empty? Because everybody, it's obvious, everybody knows that Buhari no more. Buhari is dead, yeah. Man.
Onyishi, Mazi, Osko, KK, our Asian national rep, thank you very much for giving me such a wonderful opportunity again to talk about the late Buhari. Yes, to talk about the late Buhari. It's quite unfortunate. It's quite unfortunate that our people really don't want to come to their senses, only but few. And those few can only be seen in IPOP. Yes, our Onyendu Maze Nnamdi Kanu has already raised the alarm. And most people has come to their senses to realize that actually Absol Rock is empty. Myself, sometimes years back, I said it. Even in a live broadcast, I said that Buhari is no more. And indeed, Buhari is no more. There is no two ways about it. And we are very much intelligent that we understand that Buhari is no more. Even the Queen Elizabeth, sometime in February 2017, sent a condolence visit to Nigeria. And he said, the death of the President Buhari comes to us as a shock. He has been one of the active pillar in Africa. May the good people of Nigeria and Africa know that our hearts are with them. That is a condolence message. And he said, and she sent it, and it was there on air. Our Onyendu Maze Nnamdi Kanu has been lamenting about Buhari no longer in existence. Can you also recall that an ex-British lawmaker in the person of Eric Joyce insisted that Buhari is no more? You know what matters most is that if these people can categorically, just like the British ex-lawmaker Eric Joyce said that Buhari is no more, that's supposed to be a talk of the town. The Nigerian government supposed to sue Eric Joyce to International Criminal Court for alleging that their president is no more. But they sweep all these allegations under the carpet because they cannot say it. Buhari is no more. Buhari is no more. It's just presidency. I only salute one of them in the person of, what is this guy? I will remember his name. An ex-senator, mm-hmm. A celebrity senator, what is that his name, has come up to say, Dino Malayi has come up to say that Buhari may be in transition, or maybe he has joined his ancestors. Yes, he said it, and nobody has ever questioned that. Why is it that the so-called newcasters or in fact they are just but envelope newcasters, people that are parading themselves to be activists that cannot be able to talk about the dead Buhari? Absol Rock is empty. But the problem is that our people have been engulfed with fear. Yeah, they have been engulfed with fear. We are not in democracy, because if we are in democracy, according to democracy we practiced when Goodluck Jonathan was in existence, a lot of people come up and said a lot of trash openly, and we are not hurt. But presently, we are not in democracy. We are in dictatorship. We are even not a military regime, because people are very afraid not to open their mouth to say something. All of them are aware. Even in Biafra land, all the core politicians, all the political elites, they are aware that Buhari is no more. Inside their bedroom, they discuss it. They talk it. They discuss it with their wife. Their wife often asks them. People are saying that Buhari is no more. They will say, that is it's true, but who will say? You want me to say that? The wife will say, oh, take care of yourself, please. Don't say that. They know that Buhari is no more. Everybody knows that Buhari is no more. If Nigerian government, according to what they said, presidency, is aware that Buhari is in existence, why is it that they cannot make it publicly? Our Onyendu Maze Nnamdi Kanu sometimes challenge and say, let Buhari come out and speak fufudi. I have seen Buhari myself in a television, sometime when he wears suit. Buhari wears suit, but ever since Buhari is no more, you can no longer see the mask wearer wearing suit. Why? Because Buhari have a bad hair. Yeah, Buhari has a bad hair. So the mask wearer can no longer wear a corporate wear, because he cannot wear a corporate wear and at the same time cover his hair, because Buhari is no more. It is very, very obvious that Buhari is no more. If anybody happened to tell you that Buhari is in it, it is typical lie. That person is just trying to maybe mesmerize your mindset to tell you that Buhari is in existence. Buhari, I know, is no longer in existence. It is just what a young boy parading himself here and there. If Buhari is in existence, why is it that we can no longer hear and talk about our first lady, Aisha Buhari, who sometimes lamented that they have hijacked her husband's rulership, that some people have hijacked it. Sometime there was a gunshot in Asorok, and you want to tell me that if Buhari is in existence, that gunshot in Asorok will be split into carpet? No. Buhari, I know, is no longer in existence. And Dino Mayani has been the only person that come up on air and said, unless maybe Buhari is in a transition or has joined his ancestors, and that is true. He said it, and nothing has happened. Why is it that they cannot drag him to court and say that he said that Buhari is in transition or has joined his ancestors? Because they know that Buhari is no longer in existence, and they cannot call it a case study because they are not ready. They are not ready to maybe do anything. Even during the NSAS, why is it that during the NSAS, there was no address by Buhari himself to the youth? Because Buhari is not in existence. There is no way you can see anything like a press conference ever since all these things have been happening, that Buhari is no more. Why is it that has never been a press conference? Why is it that that Buhari has never come out to address this issue on a press conference? Why is it that we can never see Buhari speaking his mother tongue, Fufudi? Because Buhari is not in existence. Asorok is typically empty. It is being ruled by the cabal, and they call themselves presidency. So, personally, I know, 101% sure that Buhari is not in existence. Yeah, Buhari is not in existence. He has died far long 2017. And we all know, even the whole world is aware. Yeah, and that is why the corruption in Nigeria is upgrowing. Why? Because if I tell you how much Nigerian government has spent to sweep the carpet, the allegation of Buhari, that Buhari is no longer in existence, you wouldn't believe me. But actually, Buhari is no longer in existence. And that is why the nation is going down every now and then. And there is nothing anybody can do. No matter anything you feel you can do, nobody can do anything to bring back Nigeria to its existence. Buhari, I know, will not take what is happening in Nigeria if he is in existence. But Buhari is nowhere to be found. Buhari has far long died in 2017. So, Mazi Osko KK, personally, even if it comes to swearing anything, I personally will swear that Buhari, I know, is no longer in existence. Yeah, it is no longer in existence. But the fact remains that the Britain is behind all this great, great impunity against humanity. Yeah, great impunity against humanity. And they have shot the people of the Easterners. They have shot all our political allies. They have kept them mute, because they are afraid to, because of unknown military, because of their unknown gunmen they are using. People are afraid to say anything. But in their innermost bedroom, inside their bedroom, they talk that Buhari is no more. And Buhari is no more, and that is why Nigeria can never exist. Yeah, Nigeria can never exist. But a day shall come, a day of reckoning, where people will say no. Yeah, where people will say no, that we must have to see Buhari, that Buhari must have to come and address us. And that day will come, but it will never be too long. That day must surely come. So, Maze Osko Okeke, I 101% agree that Buhari is no longer in existence. And nobody can ever convince me that Buhari, I know, is still living. The person parading himself, wearing the mask, the mask of Buhari, is just boy, a young guy. And that is why he cannot be, even if Buhari happened to have a press conference with people, they don't discuss anything. They don't talk anything. You will only see, Channel TV, cutting and joining occasion of Buhari meeting with people, but there was no discussion. The only thing they do is they pass information through paper, and Lai Muhammad and the whoever that is behind the mask wearer, they will just pass information through paper and all the rest, and that is just how the meeting will end. Nothing like Buhari talking to the audience. Buhari is no longer in existence. Buhari has far long died since 2017. Ex-British lawmaker Eric Joyce said that even the Queen of England sent a condolence visit, a message to Nigeria, confirming the death that Buhari is dead. And personally, myself, I am 101% saying it that Buhari is no longer in existence and Aso Rock is empty. And that is why the head is no longer and the body is automatically affected. Ndewo, Maze, Oscar, Okeke, I step aside so that every other person can contribute. From here, I said Buhari is no longer in existence. Ndewo.
Thank you very much, Maz Udensi. You have done justice to this because there is a very compelling evidence you give here, which since this thing happened, they never come across anything that disputed it, even neither from any media or from zoo politicians or from even Lai Mohammed, nobody. That's a British lawmaker that said it. He has address. Some people can be able to find him. But since that until today, nothing happened to that man. Because they never sued that man. Because it's a very big allegation. Even let me say the one that is even in our leader said it. Our leader is today, our leader is in their custody. Why they did not sue our leader regarding Buhari? Them forged 7 to 9 different allegations leveled against our leader, but they never mentioned. Then said that our leader disrespected late Buhari, said all manner of things against late Buhari, called him a pedophile, called him whatever. The question, why they did not say that about Buhari is late? So these people, I don't even know that if they have sound mental. Because if a normal human being cannot even bring a zoological problem, bring our leader even to keep him in their custody. Because all of them, they have a lot of disgrace and very shameful things in their custody. So for them even keeping our leader for a very long time into their custody. Anyway, like you rightfully said, who propel all this thing, mastermind all this is Britain. That is the fact. Because I don't see the reason in a country you don't have president, somebody speaking truth, you now bring that person extradition our leader from Kenya to Zoological Republic. Even keep him in communicado. Break all, violate all the laws known by human being in international. And nobody is speaking. And the same so-called human rights activists that championing human rights, Britain government will come out telling you about talking about teaching we Africans as third world country, teaching us about human rights. Imagine, they're lying. Watch us now. There are people that are teaching us about human rights. But imagine what is going on. There are people that, you go to Africa, this is a third world country, they're doing this, they're doing that, they're teaching us human rights. But we're just watching what is going on. It's only we Africans will wake up and say that enough is enough. And my pain is about our people that they don't understand. The first lady is somewhere in another country, enjoying herself. And I don't know whether they use them to bewitch all Nigerians or whatsoever. I'm sorry to use it some words, but sometimes I wonder why people are not vibrating, why people are not very mad about what is going on in the Zoological Republic. Who they're using the name running Nigeria today, so-called facility. I'm somewhere in Southeast Asia. You will see the president with his first wife, they're enjoying themselves. Go to any other country in this world, they are staying with their wife. While last in Nigeria, the first lady traveled all the way to Middle East. Leaving that place for how many months, you're not even coming back to Nigeria. What does that one tell you? Don't you use that one to know that his husband is no more? We never, even the normal thing they normally do, the first lady have a woman, a governor's wife, they always have a meeting when there was Olusegun Obasanjo. After that, in the passing to Goodluck Jonathan, the first lady then, she used to have a meeting with all these women there. They engage themselves in humanitarians. That is a normal, that is a noble things they are doing. But today, nobody talking about, Asia. No, nobody seeing her face again, not even talking in radio. And this so-called media, about expressway media, envelope media, they never speak about this. And so-called human activists in Nigeria, all of them keep mute. Nobody is talking about that one. Even if Nigeria is a type of people that is working like other, like in an Asian country and even in the Middle East, they will never allow this such an evil to happen in our country. But the African man, there is something wrong with African man. There is something wrong with the mentality of African people. That is why Nigeria is not burning. That is why Nigeria is not vibrating. That is why everywhere is quiet. That is why when they see you protesting, they will shoot you and kill you. Subdue everyone. And the people keep quiet. The first lady is no more to see in the Zoological Republic. People not asking themselves, where is the first lady? You never make any comment, but you see him in Saudi Arabia, he enjoying herself, or in the United Arab Emirates. She enjoying herself over there. Never heard from her again. But whereas in Nigeria, so-called Buhari wearer, mass wearer, we now handle things. Even media never have a media conference. You invite him, you invite media, people ask you questions, which I have been seeing different head of state are doing. Our people need to wake up and say enough is enough. This Janjaweed, they are very minority. They're not up to, they are up to 5 and 6 million in population. Fulanis, they are very minority. To open our border and allow those people, those their border, they enter into our place and begin to reach the harm to our people, killing indigenous people on daily basis. Day after day, they're killing people. And our people are keep moved. Everybody know that Aslock is empty and the people are running, they are going that place and bowing to a very young guy. Are we not ashamed of ourselves? Even when we're supposed to discuss a very important issue, we leave it and discussing, talking about 2023. Imagine. And people, even I saw in Twitter, when this useless old man called Tinubu, even started sharing rice and beans. What is eating up an African man? Are we cause? We know, very few know that nothing like president, as long is empty. Anyway, let me quickly go to Maz, because we have a lot of people here to discuss about this issue. Maz, okay, can you hear me?
Yes, Luis, I can hear you.
Please go ahead, because I'm really pissed off about what is going on in the Zoological Republic. Where everybody knows that as long is empty, people are calling them my president, my president, my president. Nobody's talking about Buhari is long dead and gone. So go ahead, Mas.
Onyisi, nobody is there. Aslock is completely empty. And there are proofs here and there. Nature abhors for anybody to allege that this person is dead. And the person who is allegedly dead cannot come out and speak and say, no, you got it wrong, or I am still alive, or I'm still in existence. If this man is alive, why can't he come and clear himself and say, I am alive? Okay, now, Onyendu, our leader, Mazen and the Kano, who also have been shouting and, you know, creating awareness about the Buhari, he is no more, he's still in their custody. And they brought seven frivolous charges against him, and they refused to include that you before you said the Buhari is dead around 2017. They didn't include it there in order to sue him in their own court. Also, they refused to sue UK former Senate. I don't know the position he's occupying, which my colleagues have said before. They refuse to sue him. They refuse to sue the Queen of England. That is a proof that Buhari is no more. Okay, today, where is Aisha Buhari? Who among the first ladies of Zoological Republic that has ever abandoned Asorok and go to another continent and start living there? For many months, did not come back. Did it happen during the time of Goodluck Jonathan? Did it happen during the time of Obasanjo? Has it ever happened before? Why was she kicked out of Asorok? Because her husband is no more. Remember the story of cockroaches RAS and the rest of them in ASRock. They are using these things, these excuses to buy time in order to perfect their plans of installing an impostor in that place. And if Buhari, I know, is above 8 years, how come the man who is now today Buhari is having a very fresh skin more than my very self at my age? Which other proof are people expecting us to give to show them that Buhari, since this Buhari, I mean, from 2017 to today, I have seen more than eight different faces, different sizes of ears. Sometimes he is dark, sometimes he is fair, sometimes he is tall, sometimes he is shorter, sometimes, you know, Buhari, who is a skeleton, now has a chest, like he's doing gym. That proves that what God cannot do does not exist. So Buhari, who is above 80 years, will now turn to be early 40. People have to rise up, because what we have there is president. And I don't know why the people are not talking about it. Instead, the people will go and start talking about BBN Niger. They left what they are supposed to do, the talk of the town, and they are start chasing rat when their house is on fire. No wonder they went and introduced him Urumini to people, so that the people mind, the mindset will be damaged. Their thinking faculty will be destroyed. All the attentions, they want to divert this generation attention into gossiping, into BBN nonsense and that of Urumini, so that they will have enough time to do what they want to do, to perfect all their strategies. Presidency. If you are coming out, Buhari, who will be before the press come and give over 10 to 15 minutes, 20 minutes sometimes, press conference. And nowadays, it's all about waving hand, coming out and wave to people and smiling. With microphone in his chest that has been mimicking Buhari's voice. And they think we don't know. That is why this Oduduwa man, that Yoruba man, what is that his name? I have forgotten his name. He will come out and doctor videos, do all manner of manipulations, and put to the public. But that is not enough to convince us that Buhari is still alive. If this man is alive, bring him out. When Goodluck Jonathan was the president, he always come out and address the people. Sometimes if there are situations that warrant his presence, he come out and address the people. But Buhari, no. Since 2017, we can no longer see our president. And people don't care. Everybody go inside his room and start watching or discussing irrelevancies. Start listening to BBN. Start talking about nonsense, things that will not give them any headway. But then you want me to believe we are normal? Are we normal? People whose house is on fire and they are chasing rats. This thing cannot happen in other countries. In fact, apart from that Zoological Republic, it cannot happen even in any other African country, not to talk of Asia or anywhere in America or European country. It will never happen. That is why I agree to what my colleague said, that Fulani is not the most corrupt in the Nigeria, but they are the most corrupt in the whole world. They perfected it by the help of the British corrupt individuals. How can they be able to sweep the death of Buhari under the carpet, just like that? Do you think Fulani is capable of doing this without having accomplices in high places? They are using the resources in our land to lobby, to bribe, to do all manner of dirty works outside, just because they have the British government as their supporter, who have been directing them, encouraging them, giving them steps on what to do at any particular point in time. They are complices to this evil, to this corruption that is going on in that zoological republic, the colonial masters. And today they will come and start teaching us, telling us human rights. They are start introducing all manner of stupid things to us. This thing cannot happen in their own very country. But they are practicing this in our own country. Are they part of this, our country? They are not part of it. But they are the colonial master. They are proving to you that you are subhumans. You are not up to the standard to be called a human. And you are proving it in one way or the other. When you left the matter you're supposed to talk about, when journalism left their work and start gossiping, when journalism will see black and say it's white, and we turn white to black, blue to red, how do you think people will take you so serious? Huh? When the military kill, they will say allegedly. When they go into a village and massacre people, they will not report it. The same thing goes to court. God, which is the hope of the common man? Where justice is expected, they will not do the needful. They are only taking orders from the Sahel, taking orders from terrorists. And Buhari is alive. Those are our what they call them. All these are our governors. They are aware. All of them are aware Buhari is dead. They are, just like my colleagues have said, they are discussing this in their bedroom. They cannot come out bold enough to speak it. The same way our own Onyendu Mazenamde Kanu have spoken. Onyendu is the only leader I can respect. I will forever respect and honor, because he has taken the bull by the horn. Uncountable times he have said it. He have called them animals, even in their own court. He is man enough to speak boldly. At Isiama Faruku, his hometown, he said Buhari is dead. Why our so-called governors cannot be able to stand up and speak? Maybe they are afraid of the military, because even last time, the next Supreme Court judge, that woman from River State, I think Mrs. Odile, her home was ransacked by terrorists in uniform. Maybe that is what our governors are afraid of. They are afraid. They are not men enough to stand up and speak. They cannot speak because they are slaves to the Janjaweed. Because most of them, they did not win election. They are there based on favoritism. Fraudulently. That is why they say, my president, my president. An imposter. Nobody knows where he come from. Because the former imposter was Jubril from Sudan. Who knows where this one comes from? Maybe he's still the same Jubril. And nobody is talking about it. The youths who are supposed to be vibrant enough to speak. Different organizations. This is not left for ordinary people alone. Students are also called to do the needful. Demand to see, demand the address of your president. But what we have today is lily-livered cowards here and there who cannot be able to speak up, who cannot be able to stand, who cannot be able to ask questions. Journalists who are now dependent on depending on brown envelope. But only the Biafra Restoration will put an end to all this mess. And this Biafra Restoration is not far from now. By the grace of Chukwuebioma, we shall get there. We shall get there. Onyisi, I will hand over the microphone and I will stand by. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you very much, Maze. That is a very nice and also analyzed very well. Let me go to Maze. Maze, can you hear me?
Yeah,
Onyisi,
I can hear you loud.
Go ahead.
Yeah, there were Maze.
There were. Raise your voice a bit, oh.
All right. Yeah, lovers of freedom, I come again once again. We all know the issue at hand. The world at large knows that Buhari is dead. Far back 2017. Like our leader said, Onyedumazi Nnamdi, he made it open to everyone that Buhari is dead. But the world keep blind eye due to corruption. I could remember when the impostor went to America to visit Donald J. Trump. After the petition for most letter, Jonathan Trump made it open to the world that man is a walking dead, that he cannot meet with a lifeless body, or he don't want to meet with an imposter. It's really saddening that the world really is aware that Buhari is no more. But they choose to keep blind eye over this very issue. Like one man analyzed, saying that even if the zoo send a madman to any country as their president, that nation will have no option than to accept it. Because they say that the zoo is the sovereign nation. But the most painful part of it is that the people in the zoo citizens, the politicians, the traditional rulers, the clergy, 80% of them know that Buhari is no more. But they cannot speak, because they are all afraid. I could remember watching Aisha Buhari on one of the programs she attended. She made it open that day that her husband is no longer in charge of the governance of the country, that few individuals have taken over. Also, she has raised several points, telling Nigerians indirectly that her husband is no longer in charge of the nation. To the extent that there was a day she nearly didn't grow out of Aso Rock, which generated some criticism that during that period, after everything, they put everything off out of the public, because they couldn't allow media, the press, raise that very issue. For us to know that Buhari is really dead, we should reason. Had it been that Buhari is alive, Aisha Buhari would not be living in Dubai instead of being with her husband in Aso Rock. It's only in Nigeria you can see a president in the country, whereby the first lady is in another country. I don't know, is that the other room Buhari said earlier that she belonged? Or that is not, because Buhari is dead. One thing with this Fulani government is that the indigenous in Nigeria, the politicians, the clergy, they are all afraid, because this government, a terrorist government, they have traumatized every person in that zoo to the extent that no one can speak. Because once you make the statement, the next thing they will come after your life. We can all see the way Omalafe Oboda was died, killed. Silently, nobody can give account of what happened to him up to today. He'd only been buried, just like that. And no one is ready to investigate what happened to him. That is Nigeria. Because he's the only man that stands to challenge him from Middle Belt, a part of Governor Otun. No other person has that courage to stand and say, Buhari is dead. No one can say it. That is the only reason they are trying to keep our leader incommunicado. Because he's the only man that has the courage and the man and divine mandate to speak such. Because Elohim called him to clean the people. Our leader, Mazen Nanakan, made it open to the world that Buhari is dead and being buried in shadow grave in Saudi Arabia. Recently, we saw a leaked video circulating on the internet from Saudi Arabia. And on that video, someone was analyzing, making some statement in Hausa language, saying that this delayed Buhari burial. And for some weeks now, no media analyze, no news will ever just make any statement concerning or to analyze that video that is in public domain. But they are all traumatized. Anyone that carries such news, they either penalize or ban, fine, it came from. See, that is the real problem with the zoo. When you have a terrorist in the government, they cover everything up with impunity. But the world knows that Buhari is really dead. Like I said, British is the engineer of everything, because Buhari died in Britain. You cannot say that British government is not aware that Buhari is dead. They are aware, but they have the plan needs to achieve their aim by covering the death of Buhari. Who can remember after 100 and something days that the post Buhari spent in UK, when he finally returned to Nigeria, we all know that he could not penetrate the Aso Rock, the presidential office, due to the security lock, security door, that use fingerprint. So they have to tell Nigerians that the rats test the president out of office in order for them to take time to reinstall all those things so that he can be able to penetrate the office of the president. I can say Nigerians know that Buhari is dead, but no one is courageous to say it. It's really saddening. We all know that Aso Rock is empty, but the world keep mood. But I thank God for this generation of Biafrans that are fearless before their enemy. That is the only reason these people are being exposed. Without this generation of Biafrans, I feel mostly led by Awonye Ndumasi Nnamdi-Kanu. By now, Nigeria could have been Islamized, whereby they can cover up the death of president. What else do you think that they cannot do? It is only that they jammed their march, which is indeed not for Biafra. And I say, may Elohim continue to bless our leader, protect him. We know that he is in the hand of our enemy, but they must release him because they have no option and he commit no crime. Buhari is there and Asuro is empty. I think I have to stop here for now. Maazi, I hand over the microphone back to you. Dewo, watching it.
Dewo, thank you very much, Maazi Chinedum. You have done justice to this. Thank you very much. Without wasting more time, let me quickly go to Maazi. Maazi Ogwim, can you hear me?
So you see, I can hear you clear.
Okay, go ahead.
All right. It is a known fact. We have every evidence to prove the fact that Buhari is dead and Asurok is completely empty. Let me start from the fact that in the EU Parliament, African Union Parliament, they observed a minute silent for the in respect to the dead Buhari. This is one fact that will make it clear to every listening, every listener. This Buhari is dead far back in 2017. And secondly, my colleagues are. Everybody in the world knows that every leader, every world leader or every country leader lives with his wife. Why is it that Aisha Buhari doing in UAE or Dubai? If that case, that should be the case. Like we said earlier about the Fulani corruption. Fulani saying far back during the time of Umaru Musa Yar'Adua, when this man got sick, it is true. Nobody can say, why should somebody be sick? But when the man is already died, they try to hide the fact that this, in order not to allow Goodluck Jonathan to assume position of number one position office, because decree, 1999 decree, it permits the vice president the position of the president in the absence of the president. Therefore, in order not to allow Mr. Goodluck Jonathan to assume the position, they said that the man is sick. He went for a medical patient or whatever. At the time, thank God for our sister, Odo of a blessed memory, in the person of Dr. Akinyele, who was the information minister then, she made it openly to them, and that was what brought her about her death. She told them that it can never happen in her eyes that this man is dead and they maintain the still alive. Using the man's name to rule Nigeria, just like what is happening today, because many of us have short memories, especially, I will not say that they have short memories. They know spineless, lily livered cowards. I mean, like some politicians, you cannot rise up and say something. They are scared, off by scared, in order not to be killed. But this woman stood her ground and mentioned, tell them that this, I must go and visit my president who has been out for months. If you say that he died, let me go and see him. Then this woman, with some delegations to Saudi Arabia, upon their arrival, they were made to understand that this man had been taken back to Nigeria. Then, when these people brought this man back to Nigeria, Nandia International Airport, upon their arrival, they took light in order to smuggle their body in. So, Fulani did not start this thing today. All this thing has been there. But there is still another fact I want to make. Out of the 7 count charges they brought out to nail our leader, Oyinduma Kanu, they forgot to put something. It's not as if they forgot it, because they knew that was the only place our leader had been, at least in their own court. Because they knew that if they eventually made mention of the fact that leader, this man is dead, then our leader particular fact to finish them completely and comprehensively in their own court. That was why they omitted this particular vital fact that are looking like a song. Why did they not say that of the reasons why we arrested, why we sent you back to zoo? Mr. Buhari is dead. So that Mazin Nandikanu will tell them that if you say that Mr. Buhari is not dead, bring him out.
Hello, Mazi. We are not hearing you any longer. Mazi Ogwim. I don't know what is going on. We cannot hear Mazi Ogwim again. I think we proceed. Mazi Ogwim, can you hear me? Okay, I think we will proceed here. I don't know, maybe having some connectivity issues. So we must proceed. I would like to also give more time for Mazi Udensi. Are you still here? Mazi Udensi, can you hear me?
Yes, Mazi Osko KK, I can hear you very loud and clear.
Okay, let me give you more time again. Please go ahead and because I know you still have something to say about Asrock is empty, because I think Mazi Ogwim having some creativity issues until he sorted himself out. So go ahead if you still have something to say about Asrock is empty and these people are lying about it and doing things and thinking all people are blind. Nobody have power to talk. Nobody have power to see. They even going through and arresting people, especially Awonian do. Why these people are evil? Buhari is no more. A lot of things are happening. So go ahead, Mazi.
Yes, of course, Mazi Osko KK. Unless anybody that is not that don't want to follow the era of saying the truth, everybody is aware. Everybody is aware that Aso Rock is empty and Buhari is long dead. That is but a simple phenomenon that we have to agree. There is no two ways about it. Anybody trying to cover up that Buhari is still in existence, in fact, that person, look at him very well. Either one way or the other, he is benefiting from the corruption in the country. And that is why Nigeria can no longer, it will never exist. It's just a matter of time. At times, I had people say that in 2023 that Buhari will be sent to prison. Oh my goodness. I begin to ask myself, which Buhari is going to be sent to prison? We all will live to see how all this drama will unfold, because there is nothing like Buhari. Which one are they going to send to prison? One thing I want to tell us is that Buhari is going to have a second death before 2023. Yeah, that is the only thing the Fulani can do. They can only, before the end of 2023, before the election, if that will come to be, because I believe there will not be anything 2023 election in Nigeria. No, nothing like that, because Biafra emergence is inevitable. That is what I can assure myself. My spirit keeps telling me that Biafra will emerge, and that is but the simple truth. So people discussing about sending Buhari to international criminal court to face the international criminal court for crime against humanity, using Lekki toll gate as a state, a case study, and even forgotten the issue that happened in Obibo, where our people was massacred in number. Even as it stands, there is nothing like Buhari to face such charge in international criminal court. The only thing, you know, the zoo is just but a drama. It is a complete drama. And the people handling the script can never be able to plot it the way it's supposed to be. That people will not understand and see that they are swimming and their back is coming out. There is no Buhari in existence. And there is no way anybody can take anybody who is wearing the mask of Buhari to international criminal court. They will only come up with second death of Buhari. Yeah, that is the only thing they will do before 2023. They will come up with the death of second death of Buhari, because Buhari has far long died. Yeah, and buried in a shallow grave in Saudi Arabia. Our own Duma Asenade Kala has already said that. And that is but the simple truth.
Yeah, and this very death of Buhari caused a lot of corruption in Nigeria because the head is already off. Yeah, the dead is no longer in existence. And that is why you see people doing all manner of stupid things in corruptions, and they see it that nobody will question them because Buhari is no longer in existence. A lot of things happen. Why are people not very wise to understand the handwriting on the wall? Yeah, the Aso Rock itself was renovated. A lot of things has happened. The news of the late Buhari is no longer a news. Yeah, it's no longer a news. The only thing is that the political elites, both in Biafra land, are all but cowards. I call them cowards, and that is what they are. They are only fighting over their pocket, and that is why they cannot stand straight to say emphatically that Buhari is no longer in existence. They only depend that maybe 2023 they will be given a slot to be the Nigerian president or vice president or whatever. But all those things are about shitting. Mm-hmm. They are chasing shadows. They are shitting shadows. I tell them that the only alternative that they used to take as a president is to join the train and get Biafra restored. Talking about Buhari or trying to consider 2023 as an opportunity for them to have Igbo presidency or whatever. All those things are about cock and book stories. Why is that people cannot come to their recenses? Coming to their recenses to understand that there is nothing like election in Nigeria, but selections. That is but selections. It is only selection that the only free and fair election that was conducted in Nigeria was in the time of Babangida. But corruption did not allow the election to prevail. The Yoruba man happened to win the election. Yeah, but Babangida, out of corruption, a Kofulani man, Babangida from Niger, decided to mix the free and fair election that brought Abiola into power. And that same thing is still happening up to date because no longer Buhari is no longer in existence, and that is why you see corruption upon corruption. You see corruption. You only hear about presidency. This presidency of 18, I'm talking about. We are hearing. It's made up of 18 people. 18 people about the presidency. Do you believe that people who are also governors are part of the presidency? Somebody like Erufai is part of the presidency. Like Mohammed are the presidency. You are talking. You are hearing all these people. Tifemi Adesina. All of them are the presidency. There is nothing like Buhari. How can Buhari be in existence and the first lady is not to be seen? The first lady is no longer in the country. There is nothing like Buhari. Buhari is not in existence. They are just trying to handle the affairs of the nation, trying to convince people that Buhari is in existence. Buhari is nowhere to be found. Buhari is not in existence. If Buhari is in existence, the allegation of our leader, Mazen Nnamdi-Kanu, let me put it that way, that it's an allegation. But it's not an allegation. It is but a mere truth. The information our leader gave to the public, telling everybody that Buhari is dead, supposed to be among the charges that they level against him. Yeah, when they try to amend the charges, they're supposed to put that one, that he gave an allegation that their president is dead, because they don't want to talk about it. They have never discussed it. Nobody has ever come out to discuss it. You have never had a press conference. You have never seen anything, a journalist coming up on air and talk about it. Nobody, no journalist has ever come bold to discuss about the late Buhari. Buhari is not in existence. And there is no way you can convince me that Buhari is in existence. They are only trying to do everything possible, humanly possible, to manage the government, to manage the economy, to manage the nation. At least we are now in 2021. 2022, they will start up their dream of 2023 election, which can never hold. It will never hold. Even if it is going to hold, that will be for Nigeria, because we are not part of Nigeria. Biafra emergence is inevitable. Biafra must come to pass. There's no two ways about it. There is nothing anybody can do because we are not part of Nigeria. And since Buhari is dead, Nigeria automatically is dead. Yeah, Nigeria automatically is dead. So having said all these things, I bring to the notice of everybody that Aso Rock is empty, automatically empty. Ndewo Maze Osko Keke for giving me a short time again to talk about Aso Rock. Buhari is long dead since 2017. Ndewo Onishi.
Thank you very much, Maze, because Biafran love to hear from you because of
the way you speak about this ASLOC is empty. Very, very indeed, ASLOC is empty. I will give him a whim another time because I hope he's having some issues with his network. Please make it very snappy and also on your side and also you are closing the market because we are about to wind it down. So, Maze Wim, after your own this man, also at the same time, give us your closing the mark. Thank you very much. Microphone to you, Maze Wim. I hope you can hear me now.
So I hear you clear. And I'm sorry that I was just talking before without knowing that my network was so bad. So, like I was saying, earlier on, I made mention of the fact that African Union Parliament observed a minute silence for the, in respect to the death of Buhari. That is one particular fact I have to prove the fact that Buhari is no longer there and nobody is in Asoro. Secondly, was the fact that out of the 7 count charges they had against our leader, they were unable to argue that leader said that Buhari is dead. Had he been the mention of that part, they added that particular part to the list of what they had against what they had against our leader. I thought our leader would destroy Nigeria completely in the first because he will ask them, he will persuade them, he will. If you say that Buhari is alive, bring him to this particular place. Conduct DNA test to him. If he is alive, you kill me by hanging. Our leader will finish Nigeria at that particular spot. But in order to prove it, to the fact that nobody is in Asorok, and then they knew that our leader was for them in this particular area, then they refused to add this to this. So, owing to this, every right-thinking human being always know and understand the fact that Buhari is no longer alive and then nobody is in that world. And secondly, I have not seen any president or prime minister around the world that will be without his wife. The wife is the husband is the president or the prime minister and they are not living together. I have not seen this type of thing before and I strongly believe that every right thinking human being will always understand the fact that this can never happen. So, secondly, this type of thing happened during the regime of
Maz, we are not hearing you again, oh. Maz, we are not hearing you. I think you are having issues. Wow. We must proceed. Hello, Maze Wim, can you hear me? Okay, you will still have chance for you to speak. Let me quickly go to Maze. Maze, okay, please give us your closing remark.
Yeah, thank you once again, Onyisi, for giving the microphone to me. Fellow Biafrans and lovers of freedom, and in fact, to all Nigerian youths, because I know that each and everyone is not happy in the way things are going on in that contraption. I call on each and every one of you to rise up to do the needful, because your house cannot be on fire and you are busy chasing rats. Give no attention to irrelevancies. You must know what is happening around you. In some same societies, the youth are at the helm of politics. So it will not be a crime if you stand up and do the needful. You can, with what is happening at the rate of unknown soldiers, unknown government, and the rest of them, SARS and the rest of them happening to you, injustices, joblessness, and the rest of them. The only option is for you to begin to come in line with the Biafrans who are seeking for an independent nation. That is the best decision so far for every ethnic nationalities and all the nations that made up Nigeria, because Nigeria is made up of three nations. Begin to stand up now. Begin to demand for an exit from that contraption. That is the only way you can live. That is the only way you will live. This is the only best option for you and I. If we really want to preserve humanity, if we really want to defend, if we really want to remain as a people, the best option is to stand up now and demand for a referendum, just like we are doing today. Fellow Biafrans and lovers of freedom, our land is secure today to an extent because of our men on ground, the Eastern Security Network. These men on ground, the Eastern Security Network, needs your support. They are the best thing that has ever happened to us as a people. And it is left for us as a people to remember them in our prayers, to make all the necessary donations to support what they are doing. Because the enemies came, the enemies in uniform, the terrorists in uniform came in form of herdsmen, surrounded our bushes and our forests. Our Ebu ESN men came and destroyed them. Now they are going into, they are now wearing uniform and attacking our people. And the time shall come when we will also meet them head on. But as for our ESN that are in the forest, you must do the needful. The needful in the sense that they need your prayers, they need your encouragement, they need your fund, your support in order to continue in that job they are doing. They are doing the work of God. So we must encourage them. In any way we are deemed fit, we must encourage them. That is all I have to say for now. I say to you, may God bless you and remain blessed until we come your way next time. I remain your humble servant, Maazi Ukeegbu Ndewonyisi.
Thank you very much, Maazi Ukeegbu. Thank you very much. That is a wonderful voice from Maazi Ukeegbu. Let me quickly go to Maazi. Maazi Chineduni Nwimo, I will also like you to give your closing remark. Use your 5 minutes, please. Greet Biafrans and your closing remark. Thank you.
Yeah, ndewo onyisi.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, great Biafrans and lovers of freedom, I come your way again. I want to use this very opportunity to remind our people important it is for us to support Eastern Security Network. Because these gallant men that are protecting our forest and our farmland are our backbone. Without them, today, maybe we may be suffering from food shortage. Because we know what the Janjaweed has in plan for us. The plan to keep our people starved, because they really came to destroy our farmland and our crops. But because of our men, gallant men, they couldn't succeed. So it's necessary and very important all rise to support these men that devote their life, sacrifice everything they have in order to keep our land safe I call our brethren to rise up this very time so that our land will remain safe. We know that the Janjaweed, after they've been chased out of our forests and bushes, they come back with military uniform in different form, police, army, navy, and other military parasites to perpetrate evil in our land. But those ones is well seen to compare what will be happening. That Eastern Security Network in our forest. People are saying, I'm going to walk. I don't know, okay? After now, all the time, people need to get to the I back at ESL or for them to stand firm, protect our land. And I also ask our people, wherever you are, to remember our leader Onyedum Azinanikan in prayer. And ask Ukabiama to protect him because he is the light that came to set us free. He is the face of the new Biafra. He is the chosen one Elohim sent to liberate his people. On this point, I will say may Elohim continue to bless all Biafrans that is working assiduously to see that our nation is being restored. From me, I would say thank you all. I remain your humble servant, Wayne Mochinebi, from the Kingdom of Wonder, as National Coordinator, IPOB Cambodia. May Elohim continue to bless you, Onyisi, Maazosko Keke, and Wachineke, the presenter. I hand over the mic to you, Dewo Maaz.
Thank you very much, Maz. Thank you. You have done justice. And we continue as we are winding down. Maz, I will give you 5 minutes if you can able to give your closing remark. I don't know if your network is okay now. Your closing remark, 5 minutes, Maz. Okay. I think you're still having some issues with your network. Let me quickly go to Maze. Maze Udonsi, give us your, with 5 minutes, give us your closing remark. Thank you very much.
Yes, Maze Osko Keke, thank you once more for giving me a golden opportunity to render my closing remarks. And I, at this juncture, I want all Biafrans to have in mind that Biafra as a nation is a great empire, And that is why it has not been easy to get that empire restored. And there is no way an empire as it is Biafra can be able to have its existence without securing its border. Our men on ground, the ESN, has already devoted their time, sacrifice everything that they could to make sure that Biafra is being saved. They left their comfort zones and found themselves in our forest. They have already chased all the Fulanis away from our forest. Even as at present, as we say, they need your support. Their support they need mainly as at present is your physical support. That physical support we talk as of today is your monetary support. They also need your spiritual support to put them in prayers. Your support is very much needed. As you are a lover of that great nation called Biafra, as you are from that very great nation called Biafra, your support at this juncture is very much needed. Most of us are often saying that we need to take the bull by the horn. How can we do that if we are not capable to be able to stand the fury of the Fulanis? We can only stand the fury of the Fulanis if we are capable enough to support our men on ground. Our men on ground, the ESN, can repel the Fulanis iron to iron, but they need our support. Irrespective of whatever you think IPOB is doing, you should remember that we all are Biafra. We need your support. Your monetary support is very much needed. You are in diaspora.
you need to support ESN. You are in diaspora, you need to support ESN. If Biafra happens to be a nation, I want to assure you that you and I that are staying in diaspora has nothing to do with diaspora. We will be the center of tourism in the whole world. That I can assure you. The whole world is aware. And that is where we need to collaborate unanimously, bring out all our efforts. All it needs to make sure that Biafra land is secured is you and I responsibility. You that find yourself as a philanthropist in diaspora, your support, monetary support is very much needed. Our men on ground need your support. If you are saying anything that we need to take the bull by the, my brother, you have to start from allowing us to see your support. Having said all these things, we have to understand that there is no way we can do it without being able to raise what it takes to stand the fury of the Fulanese. They have turned their military, they have turned their terrorists into military. They have conveyed their Boko Haram and said they are repented. They take them inside the military and be using it to terrorize our land. And that is the era we are. We really need your support, you in diaspora. Support ESN monetarily. Support ESN monetarily. There is no way we can run away from our responsibility. Listen, let me tell you, as long as you are hearing my voice this time and you are in diaspora, I want to tell you emphatically that all of us Biafran in diaspora, if we can come together unanimously, I mean 90% of all Biafran in diaspora, if we can come together, 90% of all the Biafran in diaspora, and bring out our money to support the security of our dear nation, my brother, see Biafra coming. I'm telling you, the Zoom must tremble. The only problem we have is that we don't want to bring out our time, our money, resources to support ESN. If we have supported ESN 90%, my brother, the Zoom will tremble because we have all it takes. We are more than numbers. We are legion and we can do it. This is the time for you to pick up the courage to support ESN in the little way you could. And the more you do it, I pray to always replenish the area you bring out the money. It must come in hundredfold. This time is not the time for anything but for you to render your support. We have decided to defend our nation, and Biafra must come to be, and Biafra must be restored in this very era. This very era, we must get Biafra restored. Even the last man standing must talk about Biafra. You and I have the right to support ESN. May we do that, and may Chukwu Okabiama Primehele bless us. From here in the Philippines, as the national coordinator, I convey my message to all the lovers of freedom all over the world. And I bring in the curtain to a close from my end as I hand over the microphone to our Asian rep, Maze Osko Keke, using this same opportunity to appreciate our presenter in the person of Machineke. You are really doing a great job. May Chukwu Okadama Primahelele bless you and bless you more. Give you the knowledge and wisdom to handle this very task that is being given to you as a servant of Biafra. I say, may Chukwu Okadama bless all of us listeners this day. In the name of Chukwu Okadama Primahelele, Ise.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Maze, for that wonderful prayer and also closing remark. I don't know if Maze Gwim can hear my voice. I will give you only 3 minutes if you can hear my voice, Maze Gwim. Okay. I think he's still having some issues. So, Biafrans and okay, Maze, oh yeah, go ahead. Just 3 minutes, please. I think I will not be able to make it here. So, Biafrans and lovers of freedom all over the world, we thank you for joining us for today's edition of Cross-Section of Asia National Coordinators. And we, as we promise, by special grace of Chukwu Okabiam, we will always come on your way every Sundays with few Asia National Coordinators to come and do some justice in what is going on in Zoological Republic. And our quest is to total freedom of Biafran nation, to restore our nation, Biafran. That is what we are standing here for. Nothing else, nothing more, nothing else is to for us to restore our nation, Biafra. That is why we are championing this cause. That is why we are talking the way we talk. That is why we speak the way we speak. That is why we do what we do.
because we don't know, we don't need any other thing. Only the African nation. When somebody tell you another thing, we don't accept it. What we accept is only Biafran restoration. Because we have looked Zoological Republic in every location, we see that zoo, there is nothing at all you can do in zoo that we make a zoo to be the structure. You can only restructure what you have, well, when you have a structure put in place. But Fulani have destroyed even the one-legged standing structure. They have destroyed it. So how can you structure something again when there is nothing like a structure? So we are not talking about in the Zoological Republic, there is nothing like a structure. We are here to make sure that the Zoological Republic end as even as soon as we anticipated, because we want the zoo to end at any moment from now to cease to exist. Then indigenous people nations we emerged. That people will have freedom. That people will rejoice. That people will now practice what they call the land democracy. And the world will also look black race as these people are normal human beings. They are not subhuman beings. Because what is going on in Africa, when the Western world looking at us, they will say these people are incapable of listening. I'm always ashamed of myself. What is going on in Africa? That is why we, Biafrans, we want to show the world we are intelligent people and we can be able to do mighty things. We can be able to build civilization. Only give us the opportunity. That is what we are here for and that is what we are doing. And we never relent on doing all these things. So I'm so grateful today. And also my greetings go to our leader, Mazen Andeka Nohamadike. And we continue to pray for him by special grace of Chukwukam. As soon as possible, he will go into come out from the hand of evil men and Janjaweed, and also his family and all our men and women that is in the bush and fighting for us and repelling all these Janjaweed terrorists in army uniform and police uniform, because they are the people that give license to kill and shoot at sight. So we'll continue to support them and give them maximum support that they will be able to do what they know how to do best. So our prayer is for Chukwukam to continue to bless them and to continue to protect them and all that department in IPOB leadership. For Chukwukam to continue to champion what we are doing and take control in all departments, media, religious, and every department. We have our legal team and medical. Every department, we have different departments in IPOB. I say, may Chukwukam continue to protect all of them, guide them, give them wisdom, direct their steps, because we do nothing in our own power. It's only by special grace of Chukwukam we are doing what we are doing. And also, we pray and ask Chukwukam to continue guiding all our friends and our listeners, that they may continue. By special grace of God, Chukwukam, we're going to see them next week at this same time. And also, our greeting will go to our presenter, Maas Nwachukwukikabi-Onwachineke. Please continue to do the great work. I say, may Elohim Chukwukikabi-Amapulimihenine continue to guide you and give you wisdom and also give you the power for you to continue doing work the way we do and giving you the wisdom and every enablement for you to continue to exercise your right in what you are doing. I say, it shall be well with you. And also all the head of the Director of State and all the members of IPOB, people that are working assiduously and working genuinely in order to see that the Biafra is restored. I say, may Chukwukam continue to bless all of them. And from here, I am